Sitting with all your friends, she...
Please adjust your seating now.
Now I'm sitting with all my friends.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the retirement ceremony honoring Colonel Jeffrey K. Fallesen. Today we pay special tribute on the occasion of his retirement following a distinguished military career spanning 26 plus years. I'm Technical Sergeant Pierre Converse, your narrator for today's memorable occasion. Today's presiding official is Colonel Mark Wasserman, United States Air Force retired. Ladies and gentlemen, please stand for the arrival of the official party and remain standing for the posting of colors, the singing of the national anthem sung by Staff Sergeant Ibanez, and the invocation given by Chaplain Randolph McCaffrey.
Colors, change, hut, port, hunt, forward, hurt.
Oh, say,
at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets' red glare, the bombs bursting.
Please join with me. Great God, we pause in this moment to reflect upon how blessed we are to gather this day, to recognize a stellar 26-year-plus career of your chosen servant leader, Colonel Jeffrey K. Fallesen. We ask that you would both inspire and challenge us through what we present today, captivating examples of dedication and mission success, perpetual personnel replenishment, spot-on counsel to senior leaders, continuous process improvement, and the premier training of our nation's finest warriors. We thank you for his family, friends, supervisors, and co-workers and wingmen who have supported and shaped him through these many prolific years. As we celebrate Colonel Fallesen's outstanding service, we also ask for your guidance upon his family, his wife Kimberly, and children Parker and Reagan, and as they transition out of this incredible phase of life into their next highly anticipated one. This we ask in your holy name, and let all God's people say, amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you, Sergeant Ibanez and Chaplain McCafferty. Ladies and gentlemen, ladies and gentlemen, please be seated. At this time, we'd like to recognize some very special guests, beginning with Colonel Fallesen's friends and family. A special friend of the Fallesens, accompanying her spouse, the presiding official, Miss Judy Wasserman. His wife, Miss Kimberly Fallesen. His children, Parker and Reagan Fallesen. Joining us live stream via Ustream Live, his parents, Mr. and Mrs. James Fallesen, and Kim's parents, Master Sergeant and Mrs. Benjamin Coker, United States Air Force retired. Also joining us today are, from the 37th Training Wing, Joint Base San Antonio, Lackland, Texas, the Commander, Colonel Roy Collins. The Command Chief, Chief Master Sergeant, Phil Eckenrod, and his wife, Robin. The Vice Commander, 502nd Air Base Wing, Colonel Lee Fleming. The Commander, Air Force Security Forces Center, Colonel Brian Greenroad. The Commander, 37 Training Group, Colonel Bridget July. The Commander, 737 Training Group, Colonel Jason Carruthers. Although time does not permit us to recognize everyone, the Fallesen family would like to thank each and every one of you for joining us in this memorable occasion. Also, a sincere thank you to all who played a part in today's ceremony. Ladies and gentlemen, Colonel Wasserman. Ladies and gentlemen, please stand for the reading of the Legion of Merit and publication for retirement orders.
Oh yeah, talk first, right?
Roger that.
Go ahead and say some words, sir.
I'll say a couple words.
Say what you say.
It's all right. First of all, I'd like to take this opportunity to congratulate Colonel Fallesen, Kim, obviously, Reagan and Parker. What a great opportunity for you and a great honor for your dad to have served his country faithfully and selflessly, sacrificially. We always say that about the military member, but my wife Judy would tell you that I think the hardest job in the military is the one you're getting ready to complete. And that's to be the dependent of the military member as they go through, whether he or she goes through what he or she is called to do. So I want to thank you three for your honorable service in support of your dad and in support of our country. So thank you very much. And when you get asked to speak at an event like this, and you're trying to capture in 10 or 15 minutes a man or woman's career, it's an impossible task. You just do it an injustice. I always say it's kind of like being stationed at Grand Forks, North Dakota, or Minot, North Dakota. If you try to describe it, you do it an injustice. And Jeff or Colonel Fallesen, I hope I do you justice with your career, but I'm telling you right now, it's an impossible task. The things where Jeff started and where he ended is just a phenomenal ride for him. And I apologize if I go back and forth between Colonel Fallesen and Jeff, but he's a good friend, he's a great leader, and just a phenomenal family man. So I want you to know who I know as I talk. So last night it is going away dinner. I'm listening to what's going on. We're playing trivia, and one of the questions comes up about P. Diddy. And I saw Colonel Collins jump into his knowledge of P. Diddy, former command chief, her knowledge of P. Diddy, and I said, maybe I should do some stuff about music and about singing. And so I thought about Garth Brooks and Jeff having friends in low places, but I'm not sure that would have gone over well. Then I thought about his other love of music in terms of classical music and military songs. So I thought about, you know, a tutu and tights and dancing on the stage to the overture of 1812, but I did not want him to have that vision of me in his mind for the rest of his career. So I kind of threw that one out too, and I didn't think that was going to go over very well. So as I continue to ponder what to say and how to say it, I'm going to tell you a little bit about his career. Some of you know, some of you don't know. But then at the end, I really wanted to go to his heart and to my heart with Colonel Fallesen. So, a brilliant career. He started off doing training at Shaw Air Force Base. From Shaw, he went to McCord, McCord to Barksdale, Barksdale to Columbus, and he finally ends up in at Patrick Air Force Base in Florida. And so I just want to read some things, some words that were used to describe him along the path. I memorized all of this stuff, but I told him, you need cards because you're going to go through so much stuff, you're going to get jumbled, and you want to make sure you do justice. So here we go. Magnificent leadership. Blazing record of successes. Brilliant leader. Superstar. Exceptional. Superb. Outstanding. High octane. You know, guy that works on the airfield. What a term, right? What a commander. He's got high octane as far as a leader is concerned. Take charge. Top 1%. Number one. Number one. Number one. And he hasn't even made captain yet. Well, actually, he has made captain. But these were some of the things that former bosses said about Jeff as he started his military career. And then he gets to Patrick. And probably the best possible thing that could happen to him at Patrick was not being in charge of space launches or Titan rocket launches or hundreds of, or actually thousands of sorties departing from Patrick. But that's where he met his wife. And that's where Kim came into the picture, and their journey began together. And so you see the bond of Jeff and Kim, you see their love grow, you see their passion for each other grow, and then you see Kim's love for the military grow. But most importantly, you see her love for her husband. And so that starts the path of the Jeff and Kim career as we know it today. So together, they leave Patrick Air Force Base and head to the nation's capital. Little bit of a stop at Andrews Air Force Base, but that was short-lived as he moved over to the Pentagon. And in the Pentagon, he did gut-level grunt work as an executive officer. Welcome to the military, Kim. You see, you don't even see your husband leave in the morning, and you're ready for bed when he gets home at night. That's kind of what happens when you go to the Pentagon, which Colonel Collins makes me wonder why you would want him to have a headquarters Air Force assignment after this one, knowing what you know. So you really, really love this guy, or I'm not going to say the other side, but in any event, you know, the Colonel supported him to go back to Washington, D.C. But it really is a place that young officers are groomed as future leaders. And they say amongst the officer corps that everybody has to punch their ticket or everybody has to do their time. And Jeff did that, and he did that incredibly successfully. In fact, Jeff was ranked by two different general officers while he was there. One ranked him one out of 242. The other one ranked him number one out of 250. So Jeff, in his career, continually sets the stage and the pace for what a great military officer is. And oh, by the way, along the way, I failed to mention, there were so many people in the military that called him their right-hand man. So you're probably going to see a lot of general officers running around right now without their right arm, because Jeff was it. And so if any of you happen to see a general officer without a right arm, you know that Jeff worked for them. And so you just need to say, you know Fallesen, don't you? And the answer to that is going to be, how did you know? And it's obvious, because the right arm is gone. But seriously, they did. I mean, there's probably 10 general officers / colonel that said that Jeff was their right-hand man. And so, again, a tribute to him. And along his Air Staff tour, as the exec, the same thing took place. Brilliant leader, forethought, incredible visionary. And so these words continue to stick with Jeff throughout his military career. One general officer said, He's the top 1% that I've seen in 26 years of active duty. Another one said that in his 28 years of active duty. And those are just not comments that fall on deaf ears. They're meant intentionally to let a promotion board know that this guy is hot stuff. And he is, and his career proved it as he continued to move on. I like some of the terminology, take charge. Jeff was vital to the XO's success. Here's a great line from a general officer to an exec. Jeff was the golden pen. I mean, think about that, the golden pen. And so once again, what is shown is Colonel Fallesen didn't just start now, but he started when he came on active duty. And don't forget, Kim is in this the whole way. And so she's the support, she's the part that's helping make him the success that he is today. He's a peerless motivator. Along the way, Jeff continually found people to invest in. In my life, I like to talk about one up and one down. And Jeff had that. Jeff, if you look at his life, has always been investing in people all along the way. And so there are lots of people that have had the privilege of being associated with the Fallesens in their life to date, knowing that they're going to be better people as a result of having to come across them. So then Jeff gets to go to Air Command and Staff, and then he gets to go to Korea on a remote. Congratulations, Kim. Say goodbye to your husband, right? So, except, I forgot to tell you that during that time period, Parker was born, so Parker joined the team. And then Kim actually made two trips to Kunsan, as I understand it. And I told Jeff I was doing some investigative work, and I got to put the numbers together. And when Reagan was born, and so Reagan came along after the Kunsan assignment. So then Reagan joined the family. And now you see the completeness of the Fallesen family, which is truly incredible. Some more things said about Jeff. The DCS said he's number one of 154 majors. So now we've gone from captain to major, and he continues to blaze a trail. He did phenomenal work in Korea, and then from Korea, he kept moving on. And he got eventually, you know, I'll cut a little bit short here, but he eventually moved on, ended up going to, coming out of Air Command and Staff College, then got to get deployed. So in his career, he had two deployments. Something that is interesting is I read in Jeff's career, you normally don't talk about yourself when you're talking about somebody else, but I forgot to tell him this, and he was talking about the stand-up and the coordination between Ashgabat and Kabul in terms of airspace. And I, when I was on active duty, helped set up the U.S. Embassy in Ashgabat when the Stan countries were being formed. And so pretty neat to know that I had a little piece of Jeff further down the road. But what's neat about that is if you look at Jeff's work, like say with BASH, with Bird Air Strike Hazard, his inaugural work ended up working later on in some of his assignments. So his initial work in Kabul ended up paying dividends later on because he was brought back to do some great things further on. His continued mentorship happened when he went to the Aerospace Basic Course, and then of course follow on, he couldn't hold that job down, so they moved him over to the Squadron Officer School as the Vice Commandant. But all along the way, 6,000, 4,000, 3,000, 2,000 people he's impacting along the way, which does not include the number of staffs that he impacted along the way. Because as the chief of staff for CENTCOM at 9th Air Force at Shaw Air Force Base 2 years in a row, didn't get fired. That's the other thing. It's amazing. He's an exec. He's a deputy chief of staff, then a chief of staff. And nowhere in the record does it say he moved on. I mean, so he obviously was a success. And those of us in the officer corps really understand the impact of that. That's kind of like being the chief of protocol somewhere. that if the boss doesn't fire you, then it's a good assignment. And so Jeff did brilliantly along the way. Got another deployment out of it and got to go to senior officer school. But all along the way, a Rembrandt was being painted by Jeff Fallesen in terms of what a military career should look like. So big picture military career. Now I just want to tell you real quick about him as a friend, as a colleague. There's a couple of words that, there's a couple of things I want to say. One, there's a book that was written by Simon Sinek called Start With Why, right? And so when I was thinking about Jeff, what comes to my mind, and his why, and we don't talk about this, is duty, honor, country, and family. And so for those of you that haven't read the book, you have no idea what I'm talking about. Those of you that understand what I'm talking about or have read the book, understand totally what I'm talking about. And so Jeff reports to a higher calling, higher personal calling, let alone a higher being. But Jeff's personal life is bigger than Jeff. It's actually bigger than the Air Force. It's actually bigger than the military. And that's why he operates the way he does. The other thing I want you to know about him is he's a man of integrity. And that's a lost art today. All you have to do is pick up a newspaper and see that people are willing to sell out their integrity incredibly short for incredibly small amounts of money or small amounts of position. But Jeff will not do that. He stands firm on the truth, he stands firm on rule and law, and he stands firm on his faith in biblical principles. And as a result of that, you're not going to find a chink in this man's armor. And so I think you need to know that about Jeff. The other thing you need to know, and I don't know how he does it because of as busy as he is he's an incredible family man. I know he loves Kim. I know he loves his kids. And I know every spare minute that he has in his life is going to be invested into them. And you can just look at this family right now and you can see that they have come together as one and therefore reflect who they are in society, who they are in the military community, and no matter what neighborhood they're in, you know that the Fallesen family is going to impact those around you. So Jeff, I salute you, I congratulate you, I wish you Godspeed, and I just want to say thanks. I'm humbled that you invited me to be a part of your ceremony. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Colonel Wasserman. Ladies and gentlemen, please stand for the reading of the late Legion of Merit and publication of the retirement orders. Attention to orders. This is to certify that the President of the United States has awarded the Legion of Merit to Colonel Jeffrey Fallesen. Colonel Jeffrey K. Fallesen distinguished himself by exceptionally meritorious conduct in the performance of outstanding service to the United States as Vice Commander, 37 Training Wing, Joint Base San Antonio, Lackland, Texas, from 5 June 2016 to 29 June 2018. During this period, Colonel Fallesen led Air Education and Training Command's largest wing, comprised of 16,000 airmen in four groups, two academies, and one direct reporting detachment, located at 11 bases in 10 states, supporting over 131 partner nations. His dedication to mission ensured the production of over 70,000 airmen from basic military training to sustain critical Air Force specialty codes responsible for increased readiness. He further developed over 40,000 combat-capable airmen across 58 specialties to refuel key career fields through technical training pipelines. Colonel Fallesen's manpower and management expertise during a wing staff agency personnel shortage was critical in ensuring mission success and production support remained unhindered. Furthermore, his detailed and engaged focus was essential in the establishment and beddown of a one-of-a-kind battlefield airman preparation course, which was responsible for graduating the largest battlefield airman class in Air Force history. Colonel Fallesen's unmatched attention to detail was the driving force behind his selection as a Ground Accident Investigation Board president. His on-target findings and recommendations ensured the safety of others and provided lessons learned for senior leaders to make immediate program improvements. Finally, Colonel Fallesen's attention to detail aided in guiding the wing through its 2018 Unit Effectiveness Inspection, garnering a highly effective rating in the leading people major graded area, while capturing 11 sub-area highly effective ratings and over 90 superior performance. The singular distinctive accomplishments of Colonel Fallesen culminate a distinguished career in the service of his country and reflect great credit upon himself and the United States Air Force. Ladies and gentlemen, please remain standing for the reading of the retirement order. Attention to orders. Special number, order number AL-000582, dated 30 April 2018, effective 30 September 2018. You are relieved from active duty, 37th Training Wing, Joint Base San Antonio, Lackland, Texas. Retired, effective 1 October 2018, per AFI 36-2603, in the grade of Colonel. Ladies and gentlemen, please be seated. Colonel Wasserman will now present Colonel Fallesen with a certificate of retirement from the Armed Forces. Which reads, to all who shall see these presents, greeting. This is to certify that Colonel Fallesen, having served faithfully and honorably, is retired from the United States Air Force on the first day of October 2018. Signed, Dave L. Goldfein, General, United States Air Force, Chief of Staff of the Air Force, and Colonel Roy Collins, Commander, 37th Training Wing, Joint Base San Antonio, Lackland, Texas. Colonel Wasserman will now present Colonel Fallesen with a certificate of appreciation from the President of the United States.
We already did that one. But you can read it.
Roger that.
Read it. That was what we just did.
The certificate reads, I extend to you my personal thanks and the sincere appreciation of our grateful nation for your contribution of honorable service to our country. You have helped maintain the security of the nation during critical time in its history with a devotion to duty and a spirit of sacrifice in keeping with the proud traditions of military service. I trust that in the coming years, you will maintain an active interest in the armed forces and the purpose for which you served. Those who follow in your footsteps will draw inspiration from your commitment, dedication, and sacrifices made to ensure the protection of American freedoms. My best wishes to you for happiness and success in the future. Signed, Donald J. Trump, Commander-in-Chief. At this time, I would like to invite Ms. Kimberly Fallesen to join Colonel Wasserman and Colonel Fallesen on the stage. Every retiree receives a special retirement pin as a memento of their active duty service. Ms. Fallesen will now place this pin on Colonel Fallesen's lapel to symbolize transition from active duty to retired status.
It's like blood.
Mr. Ms. Fallesen will receive a certificate of appreciation from the United States Air Force, and it reads, in grateful appreciation, the United States Air Force presents this certificate of recognition to Ms. Kimberly C. Fallesen for commitment and numerous contributions that made positive impacts to the nation's defense. Thank you for the support which gave strength and purpose to your spouse's service. Signed, Roy W. Collins, Commander, 37 Training Wing, and General Dave Goldfein, Chief of the Staff of the Air Force. Ms. Fallesen has also been given a certificate from the state of Texas. And it reads, to all to whom these presents shall come, greetings, know ye that Kimberly C. Fallesen is hereby commissioned a Yellow Rose of Texas under the laws of the state of Texas with all rights, privileges, and emoluments appertaining to said office. In testimony whereof, I have signed my name and caused the seal of the state of Texas to be affixed at the city of Austin, this the 26th of April, 2018. Signed, Governor Greg Abbott and Secretary of the State, Rolando B. Pablos. Thank you, Ms. Fallesen. Colonel Fallesen will now be presented with a gift on behalf of the men and women of the 37th Training Wing. Colonel Collins. Stage is yours,
Colonel. Okay, so Jeff has been trying to leave. I think this is our third going away for him. Like, he hasn't left yet, so Kim, I don't know if this is actually going to work out. The plane does take off at like 5 something, I know that for sure. But so I'll just echo a few things, Jeff, for you and the family. And so thank you so much for the time and sacrifices that you all have come to San Antonio and put into the 37th Training Wing. Your counsel was definitely heard, and we appreciate all that you've sacrificed to be here for us over the last 2 years and what comes next for them. And so on the other side of that, sure, it will be hopefully a Chick-fil-A that I'll get an opportunity to come there and help cut the ribbon with and maybe get one piece of free chicken. How much for just the bun? Okay. So what I would say, Jeff, is this is from the team to you and the family, something that I hope that you'll be able to put up in your house, and the team will get to see and remember your service, your selfless service to our country. So thank you, Jeff.
Thank you, Colonel Collins. Colonel Fallesen will now be presented with a U.S. flag from the 25th Congressional District of his home state, New York. This flag was flown over the U.S. Capitol, and the certificate reads, this is to certify that the flag here today was flown over the United States Capitol at the request of the late Honorable Louise McIntosh Slaughter, Member of Congress. This flag was flown to honor Colonel Fallesen's 26 years of dedicated and faithful service to our country. Signed, Stephen T. Ayers, Architect of the Capitol. Colonel great honor to present Colonel Jeffrey Fallesen, United States Air Force, retired. Woo!
That's what I get for looking. All right, so as you can see, my notes are few. Unfortunately, my former squadron superintendent, now retired Chief Master Sergeant Lamar Hurd, was unable to make it. He had plans to come here, but there was a sudden death in the family, so we had to divert. But he gave me some great words, the five B's of briefing, which are be brief, brother, be brief. And that's what I intended to do today, to keep you guys on time. But I got to start by some mandatory thank yous, because this type of event doesn't happen without a lot of people making a lot of tough things happen. So I want to just start off by saying thanks to the MTI color team in the back. You know, ultra sharp as, you know, color guard is usually pretty squirrely, but having MTIs do it, you know, it's extra special. So thank you so much for that. Sergeant Ibanez Morales had to take off, but wasn't that like the best national anthem? I heard him probably about a year and a half ago. I said, that's the guy.
Viva!
I am. Absolutely. He's awesome. Captain McCaffrey, thank you so much. And then the team behind you, just the wing staff team, Monty, Martin, Wick, Freeman, White, Rose, Sergeant Clack, Pierre, Chief Rubio, running the photo support. Thank you so much, guys, not just for today, but for yesterday, and all the support that we've had for the boss and I and the chiefs throughout our time. I'm so thankful for everything you guys do every day, and obviously for me. I want to throw a shout out to the folks on iPad land. My parents in New York, and then Ben and Teresa Coker in Florida, where we're getting ready to head down. We'll see you soon. Anybody else that shared the link with that's watching, thank you so much for being here in spirit, if not in person. So, boss, thank you so much. It's been a great 2 years. Awesome leader. Phenomenal boss. I couldn't have asked for better. I said this last night. I'm not going to rehash a lot of stuff, but I do want to say the Air Force is lucky to have leaders like you, Chief, and, well, not anymore for you, but you were fantastic too. But I'm so thankful that the Air Force has guys like you, sir, to carry the torch forward, and I know that I'm leaving, and it's just going to continue a great service, so thank you so much. Colonel Wasserman, so Mark and I met several years ago, and at an ETAP that I did up at Andrews. I thought I was going to retire at Shaw Air Force Base. We talked about this a little bit, but he was part of the panel, and there was a lot of corporate defense guys up there, and that's kind of what I thought. I always was interested in running the business, but I just didn't see that in any type of reality, at least initially. I talked to Mark, and he had this thing called Chick-fil-A, which we love. It was our go-to restaurant as it was, and then started to get to know him, and I was like, you know what? This is actually something that really I felt a calling to go do. But I was going to retire and make things happen there, East Coast. And then I was offered this assignment and show up in San Antonio, and guess where Mark's store was? And so we talk about God, mm-hmm. and how we're, does he specifically make things happen for you, or is it more general? But I definitely think that this was God working in our lives to put me back in touch with Mark and to start this journey towards Chick-fil-A. It's been a year and a half I've been in the process. And I mean, regardless of how it turns out, God willing, it will result in a store. But I am just greater for having known you. Godly man. What I would aspire to be is sitting right up here, just making a difference in this community, changing people's lives every day. I'm just humbled to know you, sir. It's been my absolute pleasure having your friendship, your mentorship, and to just learn from your example. So thank you very much for doing that.
Thank you.
So let's see. And our thank you team. So I don't know how many retirements you folks have been to, but I've been to a lot. And when I was thinking back about what I was going to say as far as my message, I can only really remember three retirements. I remember going to retirements, but what was really said? You know, good stuff, you know, thanks to the team, I love my family, the typical stuff. But I only really remember three retirements for something that was said. The first one was when I was at Andrews at Air Force Flight Standards Agency. One of the, there was a Lieutenant Colonel who was retiring, he's a pilot, and he got up and he talked about all the people that he knew from the academy on until his retirement who died in plane crashes. There was like seven dudes. I'm like, man, I'm glad I don't know you all that well. There were seven people that he memorialized in his retirement. I was like, I don't count. He left there, and I was like, but I'll never forget that. The other one was when I was at AFSENT, the Director of Intelligence retired, and he brought in a brick, and he gave his wife a brick, and said, this is the brick that I'm going to use as the foundation for the house that I'm going to build you. I was like, oh, that's kind of cool. That's a unique story. I did not do that because I'm afraid if I gave him a brick, she'd throw it at me. But I want to share the one that really made an impact on me. And it was when I was at the Pentagon, I was a brand new major, and I went to a retirement for an 06, and he was standing on the stage, and the room was packed. He had, you know, ribbons up to here, a combat pilot veteran, and he, you know, the type of, the quintessential Air Force officer that you would say, wow, you know, retired commander and all this other stuff. And he got up there on stage and he said, you may look at me and think that I've been successful. And from a military perspective, that's true. He said, but you don't want to be me. You don't want to be up here at the end of 28 years of service alone without his family. And he said, you know, I let the Air Force do things in my life that I should not have. I made rank and I got command, but I've missed out on what's really important. And I can tell you, at that moment, I seized on what that man was saying, and I didn't volunteer for extra deployments. I didn't do certain things. I put my family, at the time, Kim and I didn't have any kids, but I said, you know what? I love the Air Force. The Air Force has been great to me. I'm so thankful. But I said, I'm not going to let it. I want to end my journey with my family intact, and I have done that. And so I share that with you for if there's any, especially the young folks who are upwardly mobile and are, new families, make sure you spend that time focused on your family. The Air Force will always take as much as you're willing to give. Make sure that you put your family first. And then I want to end with one story that I've learned in my own experience that I want to share. Colonel Wasserman talked about Simon Sinek, who's a phenomenal speaker, if you haven't ever heard him. Another book that he wrote called Leaders Eat Last is a great read, and I would highly recommend it. In that book, he tells a story about a styrofoam cup. And basically, in the Reader's Digest version, is there's a high-level government official who goes to speak at a conference, and they meet him at the airport, drive him to the hotel, pick his bags up to his room, bring him from the hotel to the conference center, meet him at the door with a porcelain coffee, ready to go, sees him the way he likes it, he goes out to the lectern and on the podium, sets it down, does his speech, and then they whisk him off, he goes home. Well, he's since the next year, he's separated for government service, he's a civilian, but he made such a good presentation, they said, hey, would you come back? He said, absolutely, I'd be honored to do that. So he's now a Mr., not secretary, and or whatever his title was. He goes in, and there's no one to meet him at the airport, so he gets his rental car, drives to the hotel, finds a parking space, flips his bags up to the room, finds his way to the conference center, works his way through the front, out the back door, and gets to the back and says, hey, I think I'm supposed to speak. Oh, yeah, come on in. Coffee's over there. And he grabs a styrofoam cup, fills up his coffee, goes out to the podium and sets his styrofoam cup. And then the moral of the story is he is a styrofoam cup. His position was a porcelain mug. And so as I read that story, I'm like, man, that is so true. You know, as you progress in rank and responsibility, you might get a parking space. You might get certain privileges that are, you know, rank has its privileges, that type of thing. But at the end of the day, you're a styrofoam cup. And so I think if you remember that lesson, it keeps you humble as an individual, as a leader, and you realize that it's not about you, it's about everyone else. There are times based on your position that you need to whisk it through and take care of because your time is important and you only have so much. And that's why it's there. It's not because of you individually, it's because of your position. So I throw that out as something that maybe you'll remember in the future about a retirement that doesn't just roll off and say, oh yeah, that was fun, I enjoyed it, I really don't remember what was said. So now I want to get into some gifts. So if I could have the blue, the big blue one, or actually you can bring them all out here. Reagan, come on up. So this is for my sweet my sweet girl Ray Ray, and I'm not gonna tell you what's in it, but it comes from her favorite Buc-ee's. So I took a road trip out to Buc-ee's to get you some stuff. So. Thank you. So much. Parker, come on up, buddy. You also got a little something from Buc-ee's and a card for me, but hey, thank you. Thank you for being a good boy. Eagle Scout, you heard his Eagle Scout while he's here. So now here's going to be the top one. All right, so Kim, come on up here and join me, please. So Kim would always give me a hard time whenever I would BCS. They give you a decoration, and she'd always be like, hey, where's my medal? I want a big old bling medal. So I've seen people who, you know, they go online and they'll get like the spouse medal or the whatever it is, and I was like, that really just never did anything for me. So what I did was I made my own. And so if you'll notice, so we got the bling. As far as you know, and if you look at the ribbon, what is the first thing that jumps out at you?
Wonder Woman.
Yes, because you are my Wonder Woman. Now, but I do want to read something that I have on the back, and I wish I found it. It says, "You are braver than you believe, stronger than you seem, smarter than you think, and more loved than you know." There it is. Blingity bling. There's a card in there for you with some vouchers for some what you were thinking. Okay. So, hey everyone, that's it for me. And look at that, we're out of here right on time. Thank you so much for good. It's good to see my scout friends, my fraternity brother, and all the team that I'm and old friends. Thank you so much for coming. It really means a lot to me, and I wish you all the best in your future endeavors. It's really truly been my honor.
Congratulations. We wish you and your family the best in all your endeavors. Ladies and gentlemen, this concludes today's ceremony. Please stand for the Air Force song and the departure of the official party.
Thank you. Congratulations.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah.